My name is Jan Miles. I'm the editor of Sherlock, and I've just won the BAFTA for the drama fiction category.
What does it mean for you personally to be a BAFTA award winner?
I'm not quite sure what that means, actually, because I've never won one before. This is my first nomination and my first win. I'm pretty thrilled. I mean, it was a tough category. I have a lot of respect for I think The Fall is a brilliant show. Well, The Missing was a brilliant show. I know Steve Singleton and Jason Karuski, both as editors, and Una, and I'm a huge amount of respect for them. They were all nominees, but I think it means that because I won an Emmy for Sherlock, and I was kind of nervous tonight, more nervous than anything. But I'm now really honoured that sort of BAFTA's sort of followed suit, because I think the show sort of speaks for itself, really. And I think, you know, editing wise, if there was a show to be looked at for editing, I think Sherlock sort of pushes those boundaries. I mean, like, don't get me wrong, I love shows that have less edits in and fewer edits and hold shots, but Sherlock's good fun. And for an editor, I think that's, what it's about, you know. The rewards and challenges of Sherlock, yeah, I think it's been allowed to. I think the moment that Sherlock, you know, enters his mind palace allows an editor to sort of cut across two different, you know, sort of into someone's mind. I think, you know, we all understand in the process of editing, you know, like the sort of what a flashback is and telling story in different time frames and going back in time and forward in time. But the Mind Palace is really good fun for editing. And I think, you know, with Benedict, sort of performance is great. So I think that's the thing I took away the most, was how long one can stay, you know, Sherlock is in one moment, he's dying, and then we're in his Mind Palace for 10 minutes. You know, how long can you sort of extend that story, that belief, I guess, or disbelief? And I think that's where the most of the challenges lie. I think it took us a little while to get that right. But I think people are pretty happy with it in the end. So I hope that the Victorian, I think, which is a big trick, isn't it? However they pull that one off. But I mean, that's the beauty of Moffat scripts and Stephen Moffat scripts and Sherlock, is that it's boundless. It's endless what ideas that they can come up with, you know, which is great for television and great for entertainment, you know, so.
We're Sherlock Sound Fiction, and we've just won a BAFTA.
What does it mean for you guys to have won the BAFTA?
Well, it's fabulous. I mean, it's a fabulous show. Great. It's an honour to be recognised by your peers. And just, it's brilliant. What can I say? It's brilliant.
The performances are absolutely amazing. So our first priority is to make sure that they come across. And then we try and support it emotionally and in terms of the excitement, in terms of the energy of the show, just to give the greatest impact to all of it, really. But it's led by what goes on screen, to be fair. So we just do our best to make the best of that and, you know, actually enhance it as much as possible.
Particularly from a sound point of view, is there a particular episode or sequence that was especially challenging or rewarding to work on in that sense?
Probably the one that won this award, His Last Vow. Just such a terrific script and such a great idea. It's played so well on screen. It was just a pleasure to be part of it, to be honest with you.
Some fantastic things ahead for Sherlock. I mean, specifically, we've got the special coming up with the Victorian era. From a sound point of view, I'd imagine that presents a whole new array of challenges and opportunities.
Exactly. I mean, we're looking at the Victorian era, so obviously a lot of the modern sound effects that we use for all these flashbacks, we've sort of changed. Can't say too much at the moment because obviously it hasn't aired yet, and we've signed NDAs. So, but just look out for it. Christmas, it's going to be great.
Why do you think Sherlock remains one of the most beloved and iconic characters on our screens and in our heart?
Oh, difficult one. Flawed hero. Everyone loves a flawed hero, don't they? I suppose from Basil Fawlty, not in such a comparison, but from all the way through. Yeah, just absolutely, what a terrific character. And Martin Freeman as The Fall. I mean, it's fabulous. It's a bunch of fabulous characters in a great location. It's brilliant.
Just the pair of them is just so so professional. They're so so switched on with their characters, and they're so intuitive the way they work with each other. Just comes across on screen. I think people love that. I think they really do.